Aloha from Singapore. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to share the reason why I include explaining the concept and also ear training even at the elementary class that I teach. It is because when we play music, there must be some concept to understand the music. Based on that concept, we create the music. So imagine if I played music just based on tabs or the notation, it means I just need to know where to place on the, you know, on the sheet and on the fingerboard, and then I just press accordingly. But that doesn't mean that I understand the music. I didn't understand the music. I can just follow and it creates a song. But I'm thinking that my role as a teacher, I see my calling as someone that empowered my student to understand music. So I reveal the concept to them. There's always a logic and a system to make things easier. And based on that logic, they need to be able to feel that, to experience what the music is for them. So I'll explain about some chord characters and some chord progression. So even in the elementary class, I train them to differentiate between major chord and dominant chord. And then of course, before the ear training, I explain the detail, why is it major, why is it dominant. And upon that detail, they have to differentiate. There are some character when we are hearing the chords to make us recognize what chord they are. And then I also share the feeling of some progression. So everything is by the experience and by the tasting. You know, imagine if we are a cook, we don't just seeing the recipe and then just follow. But we also want to be creative. We want to create things out of our creativity and make it our secret recipe, right? By knowing the concept and also go through some ear training, when we play, we are able to differentiate the chord even though there's no chord sheet in front of us. It's very helpful when we write our own song because we can imagine what the sound we are looking for and how are we gonna play it out. And it is also very helpful when we do some jam session. We can play songs that we never knew before. So on the spot, we can just learn and study, oh, this is the chord progression, this is the melody. And then we can jump together with the person that we don't know, and then we just add on layers in the song. Last year, during the Ukulele Camp and Fun Holiday, we went to Batu. You know, it's a town in East Java, Indonesia. During our barbecue dinner, we watched the band that they are very tight. So I was tempted to just play along with them. Thankfully, they allowed me to play together with them. And I just follow whatever songs they played. And one of the songs is this Si Afi song. It's a Malaysian song. The title is Kantoi. It's very fun. So I just studied there, I learned, I used my ear to know what's going on. And then as a ukulele player in the band, I need to know where my position is. So I need to contribute to the band. There was a bassist there was a drummer, there was a guitarist, and there was a singer. So I need to make sure that my position won't clash with the rest of the band member. So that's why learning the concept, learning how music goes and have our ears trained will give us such a wisdom and insight about how to put ourselves in that situation. Okay, let's enjoy this.